ready.
Okay. We love a project with a lot of ink for its buck.
And we know you do too. So today we've teamed up with Pure Bond Plywood to show you how easily and inexpensively you can build your own 9.5-foot sliding barn door media console.
And with only a few sheets of hardwood plywood.
Let's get to work. So here's where we typically tell you all you need for this project is boom, boom, and boom, but there's a lot on this one.
So you can go download the free printable plans from our website, link is in the description box, and it's got a supply list for you to shop from.
So we're using Pure Bond plywood to build the shell of this cabinet.
Pure Bond is our favorite plywood to use because it is beautiful, it stains beautifully, it looks like a solid piece of hardwood, and that's why we started using it, but it's also formaldehyde free.
And one of the great things about it, it's actually sold at Home Depot in 4x8 sheets, so it's huge. So if you're in a car like ours and don't have a trailer, they will actually cut it at Home Depot for you, which is what we did here. So these are 15-inch cuts, and then we'll take our miter saw and make our shorter cuts, which is what we're doing right now. Now we have a piece of wood.
Time to work.
So the first thing we're gonna do, we've made our cuts. Now we are going to take our long tower pieces, and these are gonna be the sides of both bookshelves, and we are going to be marking where we're gonna line our shelves up. I don't know what Ashley's looking for.
I'm looking for a pencil. Don't worry, guys. She has breath strips and mints, but no pencil.
And a painter marker.
Receipts. I have lots of breath strips. What does that tell you?
What we're gonna be doing is marking where each of these shelves line up, starting from the bottom. Now, I would suggest using a speed square on this part, but my kids took mine, and so I don't have one currently. And because I can't find my speed square, we're just using two little scraps of wood to make lines to line up our shelves. And this is just gonna show us where to line up each shelf, and it will help when we start to attach this big guy. Lines are made, so what we're gonna do now is we're gonna attach the shelves on one side. So Ashley attached that first shelf. I'm going to slowly attach the second. Just when it's nice to have two sets of hands. One to drill and one to give moral support. I would also like to say, guys, that a unit like this at like a big box retailer at this size would probably cost $3,000 to $4,000. And we are gonna build this guy for under $500 with hardware.
And I think it looks better than a retail store.
Yes, I do too. All the shelves are attached. Now we're gonna flip this thing over and attach it to this side. The line is gonna be the bottom of each shelf. So I'm lining that one up bottom, and then I'm gonna go ahead and attach those with the 1¼-inch pocket hole screw. So at this point, we're gonna be adding two pieces of wood, a 2x board and a 1x board. The 1x is going at the back of the top. The 2x is going at the front of the top. I'm attaching the 1x3 board for the back. And what this will do is allow me, when I get this up on the wall, to go through this board and into the wall to keep it from tipping. Things you think about when you have 6 kids.
Okay, I am attaching this 2x4 now, and it's going to line up 1½ inches from the top. And we're not gonna worry about these showing because once we have the trim and everything done, you're not gonna see that.
At this point, we have...
How lightweight that is, by the way.
At this point, we have one of our bookcases built. We're gonna build the next one, and then we'll move on to the middle part.
Okay, we have the second tower done, and now it's time to build that middle console part that the TV goes on.
We're gonna start with the top board, and this is actually gonna be what the TV sits on, but we're going to turn it upside down. So whichever side is prettier, whatever you're looking for, in this case, we're gonna be painting, so we'll probably go with the smoother side. And we'll face that down on the ground, and we will add our two sides first. Now, a good tip on this part, I designed this to fit a certain kind of basket, but you have your own storage needs. So if you have a certain size basket you wanna do, you can definitely measure this part out to fit those baskets or to fit what you're needing to store and modify it, which is one of the great things about DIY. I needed to hide all the stuff. Well, actually what happened is I lost my office space when I gained a baby. So this holds like all of my office stuff, like my papers and my important things. Pens, pencils.
Important things.
Important thing.
Popcorn.
Candy.
Wine.
It's all hiding there.
Hide your crazy.
Hide your crazy. Okay, so we have center mark. This is exactly where we're gonna line our divider board up. Now we're gonna attach the bottom shelf. This is the bottom of the middle console. Now we're gonna add a line of wood glue down this middle shelf right here. And I'm also gonna put a line just below the lines that we just made. Okay. So we'll attach the sides first based on those lines that we made. Works for me.
So all of our beginner woodworkers, if you can build any one of our little consoles with the plywood, you can build this because it's just a bunch of little bookcases that we're putting together. And then you add the face frame and the doors and the sliding doors, and that's what gives it the unique look.
All right, middle section is done. Now, this is where you need to pay attention.
So we've built our two towers right here, and we've built this middle console.
And now we're gonna show you how it all comes together.
Typically, we would take this inside the house, attach it to the wall, attach them to each other, and then finish it. But since we are filming this for you guys, we wanna show you how it is in the shop. All right, tower one. All right, halfway done. Now we're ready to order lunch or finish the project and get it trimmed out. But first, order lunch.
Okay. So while we're waiting on Ashley's lunch order to arrive, we will go ahead and show you guys how this is gonna come together. So the first thing you're gonna do, once you get them in place where they're gonna sit, is to attach these three pieces together.
And we are gonna do that with wood glue and wood screws.
So I suggest coming in through the cabinet bases and into this part because those will be hidden. And be sure to use wood glue. We're not using it on this part because we are gonna have to get this out of my garage.
Done.
Awesome. All right, next step is going to be adding these two pieces. This is exactly what we did on the two towers, but we're going to attach both of the towers together now above that base that we built. So your 2x4 is gonna go along the top. Okay. Now we're gonna go around to the back side and add the 1x3. Ashley helped me hold, but she's a little bit taller than me. I can't reach it at all.
Shaney fact, Ashley is 2 inches taller than Whitney.
And I'm feeling every inch of it right now. Perfect, okay, so now we are ready to trim this baby out.
Now, you can see the edges right here. Since we did build this with the Pure Bond plywood, we're gonna have this rough edge right here. To make this look like a solid piece of wood, we're just gonna cover that with a face frame.
Yes, we are. Now, our face frame is 1x3 and 1x4 boards. We're gonna start with our baseboard. All right, the baseboard is a 1x4 board, and we're gonna start with our sides down here. Now we're gonna add this front piece. This is a 9.5 foot board. Woo, hello. And it's gonna line up flush. All right, baseboard is attached. Now we're gonna be trimming out this entire console.
Now it's time to trim the rest of it. And this is where you really need to download our plans and measure and cut as you go.
Every measurement's gonna make a difference. So 1/8 of an inch, you're gonna see.
You're going to be going in and out of the house a lot on this part.
It's good exercise.
Work those feet.
Absolutely. Trim is finished, and now we get to move on to the optional stuff.
We love options.
We do. So we're gonna start with doors. Doors are totally an option here. We are building ours using 1x3 boards. We've added 3/4 inch pocket holes to two of our boards, and we're attaching those to create the frame using 1 1/4 inch pocket hole screws. What about the back?
The back is also optional. If you've got a beautiful wall that you want to show through, leave it open.
Sometimes you have to hide the ugly, and it's really easy to do. Just refer to the plans. We'll show you guys the cuts that you can make on your 1/4 inch material for that part.
And you're gonna attach it just like you attach the back to the doors.
Easy peasy.
Fine.
All right, final option is that middle shelf. And I added mine because I wanted more baskets to hold more stuff.
She's got a lot of kids.
I do.
Got a lot of stuff to hide.
So refer to the plans for that. Super easy to attach at the end, and you can actually line yours up wherever you want it to fit your storage needs. And that, my friends, is a 9.5 foot.
Well, we forgot about the barn doors.
It's the most important part.
Final step to give this guy some character is the barn doors.
That's right, and we have a great video on how to build your own barn door, and it's a hack, guys, because we build them very inexpensively and they're super lightweight.
And so we're putting a link somewhere on this video. I don't know where it will go. And then we're also going to link to that how-to in the description box below. And we will also add a link on our plans.
All right, guys, there you have it. In just a few hours, we built a 9.5 foot sliding barn door console.
With about 4 sheets of Pure Bond plywood.
Yes.
That's it.
That's
it. Now it's time to get some awesome hardware on the doors so that we can attach the doors.
We'll be linking to all of that below so you can see exactly what we use. And I think Ashley said it perfectly. This piece is the perfect example of meeting form and function. When you have the doors open, you can watch your TV. But when you're ready to close it off, you've got beautiful bookcases just to show off everything.
And this is a project for beginner woodworkers. This is all modular, like we told you earlier in the video. Mm-hmm. So if you've never built a big piece of furniture, this is the perfect one to start with. Don't let the size intimidate you.
Definitely customize it, make it your own.
And send us a picture and use the hashtag ShaneyToChic.
Now, we get to go eat now. What'd you order for lunch?
Salad. And bread.
Candy. This is usually where...
All right.
Next up, that horizontal... Next, we're adding the... Now, we're asking Lauren what's next. Next, add that. Oh my God!
Yeah. Like, woo, yeah.
Okay.
Work those feet.
Absolutely.
My breath stinks. I'm sorry.
Mine.
Not so good.
It only took me one try.